G'day, g'day! How the heck are ya? Welcome to Roverland! This is your friend Dano! Ha! Ha! We got something for you today! Yeah, check this out! Yeah, we've got ourselves another Corgi Whiz Wheels Vigilant Range Rover! But this one's a little bit different. Yeah. So, let's take a look around this vehicle here. What we've got is a 1/43rd scale Whiz Wheel produced number 461. Let's just get into that. Number 461, produced from 1972 to 1979, UK Police, with white, with like a dark blue and red sticker on the side. Police up on the top there. A little bit different roof configuration on the top there. Accident in the back. But pretty much their same casting of the 482, but just a little bit different. All right. So, very nicely detailed. We have looked at that. Now, this one does have, interestingly enough, opening doors that slide open and close up and down there on the side. Black plastic, not, you can't see through there. Plastic tires as they had before. And then on top, they have a blue bubblegum in the middle, police on the front, accident in the back, and then two spotlights. And those spotlights do turn. They do have a amber plastic insert. These are plastic, so very delicate. As you notice, some of mine are missing them. And there you go. They just spin around as much as they can. But there it is. They did now. The other one didn't have this tab on the side to keep that in there. If they did, it was covered up. This one, that tab is showing on there. The ambulance has a solid, lights up front, but that's about it. Two blue bubble gums up front, but a larger full length roof extension, I would call it. But very nice. Metal on metal, Range Rover, red interior. This is a right hooker, and this is where the fun begins. It has a rear opening hatch, so the tailgate lid goes up and the tailgate goes down. And there we can see kind of a little bit better in this one. I believe it does share the same interior as the 482. No, it's a little bit different. Yeah, it is different. One is because the that sliding compartment, it's not even a window, sliding compartment on the side. So very, very kind of cool. I really like this one. This is kind of maybe the best of the best that I have. A little dirty, that's the way I got. Now, most of these I got off eBay. There's no way I'd find such a thing like this hanging around Wisconsin. This maybe be the best of the best. Yeah, really kind of nice. And I'll tell you why I think this is the best of the best. All right, very nice. Well, it is missing the sticker there, the police sticker up front, but it's got something else. And these models came with attachments. Whoa! Holy cow, everything spilled right out. Yeah, they came with stuff. All right, so let's adjust our camera here a little bit so we can take a look at what we got. They had a little tray that goes in and out of there. Just fits in there and it slides in there nicely. And I hope I didn't lose all my little cones. It comes with little cones. I don't think none fell on the floor. I think you got enough cones to put on each one of those six cones. I think I just didn't have them. But then it comes with these unfoldable little signs. Try folding. And then they stand up and they can direct traffic this way or that way. All right. And I bought these on eBay. Now, I don't know exactly, I'm always a frugal shopper. What is this one? Anyway, you see how it works. Police and police accident. Yeah, so those are supposed to fit in here like this. And then you can fit the whole contraption, the whole kit and caboodle. Get them in there, shake them around, shift them in there. And then the little cones, I believe there's 6 cones that go on there. They go in them little holes. There's 2 rows. Am I even in frame? But there you go. So, and then that just goes ahead and slides right into that cavity there. Yeah, nice big opening. There it just slides right in there. If I can get that in there. Can I get it in there? No, that one sign's going to be a little bugger. A little bugger in there. I bet you maybe I'm supposed to flip one of those over so they fit a little bit better. How's that? Huh? We'll flip one over and see if that helps the HR shoving stuff in there. Ah, good old Ace. Thanks a lot, HR shoving stuff. Now I'm losing one of my cones. All right, so there you go. Pretty nifty. Play value is up out of the roof on this one. I know, I'm not going to get that in there for some reason. There it goes. We'll just shove her on in there, right? No, we're not. No, we're going to have to deal with that one later. All right. Anyway, so that's a pretty nice one. Let's get back over here so we can see what else we got here. All right, get that. So, took a look at that one, Taylor. This one, I think I've got some parts with this one. This one's missing. This one's got. Oh yeah, see now those are black. Oh, see they're supposed to go like that. Way to go, Dan. Yeah, now you got that shoved in there. You can't get it out. And now we're gonna have to call a captain, and he's gonna have to come out here and fix that. Oh yeah, that's HR shoved and stuffed right in there. But anyway, there you go. There you go. This one, like I say. Missing a. I think you can buy these. Like I say, they're very delicate. I think you can buy these on eBay and replacement parts and such like that. Now I don't have any cones with that one, but I think they came with a figure too. I'm not really sure on that, but very very nice heavy model. One 43rd scale. Now I do buy anything and everything. In all kinds of conditions, because someday on this channel we are going to get into restorations and stuff like that. So and maybe get into some customization. But here's one that's pretty well beat up. It does have good glass. It does have these rolling door cabinet things. Missing a glass on that rear. Hatch there, but that I think that's would be pretty easily replaced if you're any kind of resourceful. All right, the last one is the last one that I purchased, and come down to me, it's a custom. Yeah. So there you go. Got the roll down things. We've got the sticker of the Red Cross on there. Don't mind cleaning off all of the label stickers on the side. Just paint right over it with your mom's varnish. But not too bad. I don't know if this is copied after a certain livery or what. Whoa, no, that's white in there. So very interesting there. I don't know the blue and yellow, and I'm not really sure what 9144 means, if that's anything over in the UK. But missing the lens on the one searchlight there, and painted the bubblegum, yellow bubblegum ball machine there red. But I don't know if that's like an airport security police accident thing or what, but pretty interesting. So I picked that up. There was a fellow on eBay, and he was selling off his some kind of collection. And he had quite a few, and I got a couple, and he thought he had something, but he wants a lot of money for it. So it's like, yeah, buddy, I'll take all your stuff if you want to be reasonable with your price. But I got a couple of things out of them. So there we go. Do you have any of these? This is just, I'm sorry, but this one's just bugging me now that I HR shoving stuff that in there. There we go. Oh, thanks guys for sticking around with me on this here. We're going to get this back together and put it back together right. So they fit down like this. Yeah, those were gray and that other one was black. I don't know, not really sure what is newer or older or anything like that. But if you know, hey, please comment in the comments down below. Let me know what, if you got any kind of information. It's kind of hard to find information on these, but not too bad. But there you go. Now we'll get it slid right in there nice and neatly. There we go. Now the captain will be happy. All right. Well, that about does it for today for the Corgi Whiz Wheels. This is the Range Rover Vigilant, but it's the number 461. Yeah. How many of those do you got? You got some of these? Well, come on over to Facebook, Roverland, and show me what you got. Come over on Instagram, Roverland Channel, and post what you got. I'd like to see all the different variations or conditions of the 461 Range Rover Vigilant. Yeah, pretty awesome. All right, we're gonna call it a day. Thanks for joining me today, and remember, slow traffic, keep right, and have a great Rover day.